What's good, guys? It's Saturday afternoon, or rather evening, and I just wanted to update people on the lawsuit that Miss Teressa Martin has filed in regards to the incident that happened to her daughter, Kenneka Jenkins, at the Crown Plaza O'Hare in Chicago, or Rosemont, rather. And, anywho, also wanted to, do just kind of an update on it. And maybe there's a lot of people that still, or that are new to the, J4K community that haven't heard any of it. I believe I did a video on it, but, regardless, the case is styled, Teressa Martin, Special Administrator, Kenneka Jenkins, Deceased, versus Capital Security Investigations, CPO Hospitality, LLC, doing business as, Crown Plaza, Chicago, O'Hare, doing business as F&F Realty, LTD, MBC, Rosemont, LLC, and Murray Brothers, Caddyshack. The case was filed on December the 11th, 2018, and the case number is 2018-L-013273, and basically, the update to the case is that it was supposed to have some activity in March of this year. And I'm going to go down to that date. I've had a lot go on in this case. But cases like this drag on and on. Alright. Excuse me. Okay, they were supposed to be in court on the 17th of March, and, because of the COVID-19 situation, the court entered a continuance and reset it for April the 16th, 2020. So since that has passed, well, let me back it up. So the court then sent out postcards telling all parties that the case had been rescheduled to April the 16th. So you'll see this postcard generated, and it went to Capital Security. Postcard generated on the 18th of March, one for Teressa Martin. Postcard generated, one for Teressa Martin as Special Administrator for Kenneka Jenkins. Then they sent an electronic notice to CPO Hospitality, an electronic notice to NBC Rosemont LLC, an electronic notice to Teressa Martin. However, excuse me, on the 18th, so that was on the, what day was that? The 17th, okay. So it was continued on the 17th. On the 18th, they went ahead and set the case for trial. And they set it for, try to make this bigger, June the 16th, 2020. Which may be a very optimistic date for the courts, all things considered. Because you have to take into consideration that the court's going to be backed up from being closed for so long. And I know that the steps going forward were going to be, once we come out of this, it's going to be like groups up to 10 will be allowed, and then groups up to 50 will be allowed. So that's going to take probably till the end of the year until we get really situated. So I have a feeling that that date is really being optimistic, and I feel like they'll probably reschedule that. But anywho, they sent a notice to everyone on the 23rd, letting them know that it had been rescheduled. And on the 15th of April, the court filed the proof of service where they had sent it all to everybody. They got all of the cards back, postcards, where they had served everybody, telling them what date the court trial was going to be. And so they filed proof showing that the service had been done. So that's where the case stands right now. So as of right now, this case is set on the docket for 6:20, I believe I said. No, 6:16, my bad. 6:16 is when this case is set to be heard. So we'll see. But anywho, I just wanted to update you guys on what's been going on in the case, because I was curious myself. I knew that it was supposed to happen in March, and then I never heard anything, and I assumed they had rescheduled it, but I just wanted to be sure. So I thought I would share what I found with you guys. Hope you have a great evening.